It's no secret that I love a good spy thriller novel, especially when the cover involves a silhouette of someone running. One of my favourite series to read when I was growing up was the David Morrell trilogy, The Brotherhood of the Rose, The Fraternity of the Stone, and The League of Night and Fog. I loved the combination of spy, assassin, secret religious group, conspiracy stuff. It probably seeded my ongoing love for this kind of story. So imagine my joy to discover The Venice Conspiracy by John Trace. You may have also seen the same book with Sam Krista as the author. That's because Krista is a pseudonym that Trace uses. So what's it about? When ex-priest Tom Shaman decides on a last-minute trip to Venice, he gets much more than he expected. A brutal killer is on the loose, and Tom finds himself in the midst of a series of ritualistic killings unlike anything Venice has ever seen. Enlisted by the Italian police, Tom teams up with investigator Valentina Morassi to dig deep in the city's darkest history, stretching from an ancient civilization to 18th century Italy to the gritty underworld of modern day Venice. As Valentina and Tom trace the killings through the centuries, they uncover a deadly secret that generations have killed to protect, a priceless mosaic known as the Gates of Hell. I read books like this purely for the escapism and to break up heavier topics like war and politics that I also like to read. The Venice Conspiracy does this well by being a well-woven tale and a mystery that will keep you going right to the end. It's more of a police investigation story than a spy thriller, but by switching between the present-day investigation and two historical time periods, Trace keeps you interested. He'll stay with one time period, build things up, and then leave it at a cliffhanger while he switches to another time period. He does this well and to good effect, and at no time did I feel bored or frustrated with how it was all laid out. It's very, very well done. I've since discovered that there's a second book with the same lead character, so based on how much I enjoyed this one, I will definitely be tracking it down.